Hello everyone. In this class we'll discuss inverse transform of logarithmic functions and inverse functions. Given f bar of s, we need to find L inverse of f bar of s. We know that L inverse of f bar of s is f of t. We have the property that this is one of the property of Laplace transform, that is Laplace transform of t into f of t is equal to minus f bar dash of s. Equivalently, it can be written as L inverse of minus f bar dash of s is equal to t into f of t. In Laplace transform, we have studied four properties. In that, another one property is this one. That is, Laplace transform of t into f of t is minus f bar dash of s. We have to use this result while solving these examples. Working procedure. In this case, the logarithmic function, in this case of logarithmic functions, we apply the property of logarithms and then differentiate with respect to s to find, to obtain f bar of s. We then multiply by minus 1 and take inverse on both sides. Next step, LHS becomes t into f of t by equation 1, and inverses are also found for the terms in RHS with the result we obtained in the required f of t. Means first, we, for the given logarithmic function, we have to use the suitable logarithmic functions properties to find f bar dash of s. You have to differentiate that f bar of s to with respect to s to get f bar dash of s, then multiply minus 1 on both sides and apply the L inverse. After that, you get t into f of t by using the equation 1, means using this result. Now, if logarithmic function persists in f bar dash of s, we differentiate again with respect to s to obtain f bar double dash of s and use the property that L inverse of f bar double dash of s is equal to t inverse into f of t, which is Laplace transform of t square into f of t is f bar double dash of s. Means the given function is of the form f bar dash of s, then you have to use this step. In the cases of inverse functions, we simply differentiate the given f bar of s and use the result 1 to obtain f of t. Okay, next go through the examples. Here, find the inverse Lt of the following functions. Here we have 5 functions. Let us go to the solutions one by one. Solution for the first one. Let f bar of s is equal to log s plus a divided by s plus b. Here you have to use the logarithmic properties, that is log of a by b is log a minus log b. So use that result. That is, f bar of s is equal to log of s plus a minus log of s plus b. Now differentiate this with respect to s and multiply minus 1 on both sides. You get, that is, multiplying minus 1 on both sides and differentiating with respect to s. I am multiplying minus 1, this is minus. Differentiating with respect to s means it is f bar dash of s is equal to, this is log a, differentiation is 1 divided by a, that is 1 divided by s plus a minus 1 divided by s plus b. Here we have to multiply minus 1 on both sides, therefore it is minus of 1 divided by s plus a minus 1 divided by s plus b. When we simplify this one, minus f bar dash of s is equal to, this is minus, this is plus. I will write first positive term, minus into minus plus, it will be minus 1 divided by s plus a. Now we have to apply the L inverse. Now L inverse of minus F bar dash of S is equal to L inverse of 1 divided by S plus B minus L inverse of 1 divided by S plus A. We know that L inverse of 1 divided by S plus B is e raised to minus bt. This is minus 1, and L inverse of 1 divided by S plus A is e raised to minus a t. Therefore L inverse of minus F bar dash of S is equal to e raised to minus bt minus e raised to minus a t. Here we have to find the F of t, so that since we know that L inverse of minus F bar dash of S is equal to t into F of t, therefore t into F of t is equal to e raised to minus bt minus e raised to minus at. Therefore F of t is equal to e raised to minus bt minus e raised to minus at divided by t is the required F of t for the given function. Thus F of t is equal to e raised to minus bt minus e raised to minus at divided by t. Now solution for the second one. Given F bar of s is equal to log 1 minus s square divided by s square. This can be written as log of s square minus a square divided by 2. Then again use the property of logarithmic functions. You get F bar of s is equal to log of square minus a square minus log s square. Log s square can be written as 2 log s. Now multiply both side minus 1 and differentiate with respect to s. Multiply minus 1 on both side and differentiating with respect to s, we get minus F bar dash of s is equal to, this is minus, keep outside. Now differentiation of 1 divided by log s is 1 divided by log s square minus a square, and differentiation of s square is into 2s minus, this is 2 constant, differentiation of 1 by log s is 1 by s. Then in these two terms 2 is constant and also common, take outside and multiply this negative sign to this one. When we multiply this one, first term is negative and second term is positive. I will write positive term first. 2 take common, then it is 1 divided by s minus s divided by s square minus a square. Now apply the L inverse. This is F bar dash of s. L inverse of minus F bar dash of s is equal to L inverse of 1 divided by s minus L inverse of s divided by s square minus a square, which is equal to 2 into L inverse of 1 divided by s is 1 minus L inverse of 1 s divided by s square minus a square. Here, since here it is minus sign, we have hyperbolic functions, that is cos h a t. Then it is L inverse of minus F bar dash of S is equal to this one. We know that minus F bar of S is T into F of T is equal to 2 into 1 minus cos H A T. Therefore F of T is equal to 2 into 1 minus cos H A T divided by t. This is the required f of t for the given function. Use all the steps while solving these examples. Simply you have to use the first you have to use the logarithmic properties. After that multiply minus 1 on both sides and differentiate with respect to s. Then after that, after simplification of that, you have to apply the L inverse on both sides. And we know that L inverse of minus f bar dash of s is t into f of t. Write that one and find what is f of t. Next example is given f bar of s is equal to log of square root of s square plus 1 divided by s square plus 4. Use the logarithmic properties. We get log of s square root of s square plus 1 minus log of square root of s square plus 4. We know that log of square root of s square plus 1 is half into log, because this can be written as s square plus 1 raised to 1 by 2. Therefore, it is 1 by 2 into log s square plus 1 minus 1 by 2 into log s square plus 4. Now, multiply minus 1 on both sides and differentiate with respect to s. We get minus f bar dash of s is equal to multiplying minus, and in these two terms 1 by 2 is constant and common, take outside. Differentiate these two. Okay, now log s square, differentiation of log of s square plus 1 is 1 divided by s square plus 1, and differentiation of s square is 2s minus 1 divided by s square plus 4. Again, differentiation of s square is 2s. Now it will be this, when we multiply this negative sign to this one, first term is negative, second term is positive, and multiply this 1 by 2 to this one, we get this 2 cancel with this one, and this 2 cancel with this one. We get s divided by s square plus 4. This s remains, 2 get cancelled. This is minus into minus plus. This is minus s divided by s square plus 1. Now apply the L inverse. L inverse of minus f bar dash of s is equal to L inverse of s divided by s square plus 4 minus L inverse of s divided by s square plus 1, which is equal to L inverse of 1 divided by s square plus s divided by s square plus 4 is cos 2t, because 4 can be written as 2 square. Here a value is 2, therefore cos 2t, this is minus cos. Okay, this is what L inverse of minus f bar dash of s. Then this can be written as t into f of t is equal to cos 2t minus cos t. Therefore, f of t is equal to cos 2t minus cos t divided by t. This is the required L inverse for the given function.